flying show, guys, a packed show today. First and foremost, we're going to have Tough Cooper come out. And then after that, we're going to bring Dale Brisby because he was just so funny yesterday. So two champions on one stage. And then after that, Miss Kylie Frye will come out and sing. And then we're going to wrap it up with a fashion show. So please welcome world champion Tough Cooper. Oh, you're sprinting. Oh, watch out.
How's it going, everybody? Sorry, I'm late.
You want to sit down?
Which one's my
seat? No, this is yours. This is awkward.
Right. Wow, couch.
Nice sprint. I like the energy.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
all that
ma'am.
Working
sorry.
Out helped, right?
And anybody that was over there earlier, I signed autographs. I'm sorry. And
it's
I'm sorry that I'm late.
Deal.
Made you a little bit nervous. My
no,
bad.
No, never. I expect it from you. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. It's a tough, busy week, hasn't it been? Already.
Yes, ma'am. Third day. I've been here since last Saturday, so I've been in Las Vegas for a week. But the last couple of days have been really busy since the rodeo started. But it's been a lot of fun, and I can't believe it's already here. We're going to the third round tonight. Can't believe it's already back.
It's hard being number one, isn't it?
It is. It is such a big opportunity for me. I'm so blessed and excited to have this opportunity to be in the position that I'm in.
Okay, Tuff, everybody knows that version of you, okay? I told you I call it the Sunday school version. And I mean, it's fun, right? It's cute for a while, but I want to know the deep, dark secrets.
I don't know if
no,
I have any
No, you sound nervous. No, I'm just kidding. We're going to have fun here, though. I don't want any boringness, so you can crack jokes. You can even make fun of me if you want.
No, I would never
do that.
It would
be nice. Ever. He can rap, guys.
No. I know somebody that can, but I can't.
You can't?
No.
Why not? What are you good at besides rodeo?
I don't know what I'm good at. I try to be the very best at rodeo that I can. I don't have a lot of other things that I'm good at.
You design clothes now?
Oh, there you go.
Hey, stand up. Strut your stuff.
I don't even.
I see it.
I have.
Work.
No, I'm not going to work it.
Oh, but he's walking around. He ran for us. Now we're getting him to walk.
There you go. I have a line of TC Performance, Tough Cooper Performance line through Panhandle and Rock and Roll Denim. I got jeans and shirts and outerwear. It's a performance fit, so it longer sleeves. The tail's longer. It's kind of tapered in. It fits. Good. I like to work out my clothes. I like to rope in my clothes, and it can kind of do whatever you want to do. And it has the same fit and feel for the jeans. It's fit for a performance, and they throw the nice Panhandle rock and roll look to it, so it has the best of both worlds.
I bet that will be a Tough Cooper Tuesday picture. You just turn around, show everybody your butt.
No.
Just saying. So Tough. Performance, you designed this, and you actually designed it yourself so that it does work for everyday wear. You made it all, like, efficient and all that stuff. And when you were coming out with it, in the past year alone, you've done a lot. It's been a crazy year for you. Came out the fashion line. You've started music videos. And you became a godfather.
A what?
Oh, my gosh. Jimmy Lee, still tough, this little
boy?
Oh,
yes. Yeah, absolutely. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, that's a big responsibility.
It is a big responsibility. Yeah, I could tell.
That is.
Did you know you were the godfather? Don't
laugh.
You say
godfather, and I'm thinking about like the TV show or something.
You feel like you're on a reality TV show?
No, not the reality TV show. Like there's a TV show called The Godfather.
The Godfather?
Yeah.
Well, I'm talking about you really are a godfather, so.
I understand. Now.
His friend Jimmy
I don't know
Lee.
If I'm ready for that responsibility yet.
Come on, you're a pretty mature guy, I feel like.
Work, yes, but I don't know. That's a big responsibility.
It's not your child, Tough. It's Jimmy Lee's, so you're
right.
Good.
You're right. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, well, let's talk about reality TV shows. You just brought it up. So if you were to come up with a reality TV show or a character from a reality show, who do you think you're the most like?
That I'm the most like?
Yeah.
Oh, geez. I don't watch a lot of reality TV shows. Why don't we take like a ask the audience or something? I don't know.
Well, I can't ask the audience. It's your question.
Why don't you tell me? How about...
This is back. Okay. Guys, when we were, 17? He won Calgary. Or what? How old were you? Like 18, 17? When you first won Calgary?
Oh, 21.
Okay, you're 21. We were young. Anyways, So I was interviewing him, and he, at the time, was not very good at interviews. I'm sorry, Tuff. And I was asking questions, and he would turn it back on me. Well, what do you think I should say? I'm like, I can't tell you what to say at your interview. Anyways, Tuff, you have gotten a lot better, so let's change it to movies. You watch movies, don't you?
Absolutely.
You know who you remind me of?
Superman?
Ricky Bobby. Like, walking around. You're like a walking billboard. So if you were to compare yourself to a movie character.
Cool. I wish that was that cool.
Okay, a while ago you said people wear a Tuff Cooper line. So if people wear it, are you guaranteeing that they're going to turn into Tuff Cooper?
It does help you rope better.
Just because it says Tuff Cooper on it. They take on a new form. Okay, anyways, though, what movie character would you compare yourself to if you were to think of one?
Probably The Rock.
No?
In which movie? Hercules?
Hercules? No? You don't see it?
I mean, maybe some longer hair and a little bit bigger, you know. No? But you do work out a lot.
I try to.
No, this is what he told me. Last year, I asked him to do this competition. I said, Tuff, will you do the best chest contest? And he was like, what? And I said, you got to show your abs, and people are going to donate money to it, and it's all going to go to Justin Cowboy Crisis Fund. He goes, I don't think I could do that, Alexis. And then this year, he was like, you know, I'm ready. He's been working out. So let's talk about your workout regimen. How do you get those abs?
20-minute abs with Jimmy Lee Caldwell.
And 8 breaths. He said you only get 8 breaths in 2 hours.
Yes, ma'am. It's kind of
weird. We kind of work out areas that we need to get better with at our roping. So it's not like we just see not very good abs, and I go to the gym and work out my abs. Like, I watch tape, and I try to work on something in my roping, and then, like, if it's this year, it has been my abs. So, like, I needed to have a stronger core this year to get better at part of my roping. I wasn't able to stay in the stirrup longer and control my calves whenever I'm spinning them around, and you need a stronger core to do that. So I watched a bunch of tapes. I figured out what I needed to get better with at my roping, and then worked on that when I roped, and then tried to strengthen that in the gym, that area of my body in the gym.
Seems to work out, Tuff.
Yes,
works out for you. And you have a tire, too. He told me he uses a tire and, what, a sledgehammer?
Yes, ma'am. There's
That's the most random group.
Sledgehammer.
Okay, tell us what you do with it. Explain, or show us, even.
No way.
I go to the gym sometimes, like, and go get my shorts on and shirt and tennis shoes and go to the gym sometimes. But I try to have the convenience of putting it right in front of me. I put all my weights out right there in the arena. I have a tire, a punching bag, some dumbbells, whatever. Whatever we're kind of working on that day, I just kind of have it all laying out in a big mess. It really makes my dad mad because I just got my junk just laid everywhere all over the arena. But I try to have the convenience of having it right in front of me. Right after I get done roping, I can go straight to my workout, or I can work out and then go straight to roping. There's no excuses for not getting in, putting in the time and the work in the gym. And I have a tire over there at the side, and I try to hide it so I don't get it out as often because it makes me really sore and it's really hard. But I still see it nearly every day, and yeah, it's hard work, but it's fun.
So can we expect a Tuff Cooper workout video soon? No, Jillian Michaels,
I'm not quite that advanced and know enough about it to have a video, but through the right training and, you know, keep educating myself on working out and, you know, how it applies to calf roping, maybe in like 35 years.
I mean, you'd be a little old then, Tuff, but it's okay. I'm not going to judge you. So, Tuff, okay, obviously you're a champion, and you do what it takes to become a champion. So, in your opinion, what makes a champion?
What makes a champion?
Yeah, like, what do you think?
Richie champion? I don't know.
Not Richmond champion. You guys know Richmond champion, Million Dollar Cowboy. What makes, in your opinion, what is a champion? Inside the arena and outside the arena, what goes into the mold of a champion?
A champion is, you know, anybody can label anybody anything. You can say you're a champion on anything. You know, a champion to me is somebody that put the work in, somebody that earned it. Somebody that, I mean, yeah, I've probably won stuff that I shouldn't have before, and then whenever I showed back up and didn't prepare like I did, when I got lucky, you know, I didn't win. But whenever I see a guy that works so hard, I see somebody that puts in the work consistently day in and day out, that goes out and wins something, and then that carries himself not only from that moment from winning that elevates you. It puts you on cloud nine whenever you win something. How you handle yourself from the moment you win and you are a champion in the arena to the moment that you come outside and you meet your fans, you meet your family, and just the way you carry yourself and continue to live every day and finish that moment out and to keep going, I guess.
That was a good answer. That was good. He's looking at me like, did I do it right? That was good. That was a good answer.
I don't know. What should I say?
No, that was perfect. That was perfect. I thought you were just going to say, Tough Cooper is a champion. No, but really, let's talk about when it's the opposite side of that, when, you know, you've been humbled. What's been the most humbling experience this past year for you?
The most humbling experience?
Yes, something that just knocked you down. You were like, ooh, brought you back down to reality.
I don't know, my brother?
Your brother? Does he beat you up a lot, Tough?
He can.
He can? Which one?
Both of them.
That's so sad. So you're like the little runt?
Pretty much.
Now like I'm trying to make us feel sorry for him.
Like a runt that won't back down, though. Like, I don't know why I keep trying, but I've never been able to get the job done.
You said you dropped Jimmy Lee once, so, I mean, that's pretty good.
Yeah, but he's a little guy.
Where's Jimmy Lee at? Jimmy Lee is not a little guy. I wouldn't say that about him, but... let's just talk about you in general. Okay, guys, I don't know if you know this, but Tuff also does a lot of community service and charity work, and he doesn't tell people about it, but he just sponsored a little league football team, got him new uniforms and everything. Will you tell us about that?
Oh, that was the most exciting
thing.
Yeah,
he deserves a round of applause. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. I felt a little bit like Jerry Jones.
Comparison. I'm a Cowboys fan.
I felt better than Jerry Jones because my team won the Super Bowl.
That was just hateful. I would never make fun of your team, but all right, let's talk about it.
It was awesome. My hairdresser has a second grader and a third grader, and I was in one day, and she was her team was looking for a sponsorship for her team, and I was really excited. I jumped on the opportunity, and you know, I had a million questions, and. It was really exciting. I got to go up there and to the practices and talk to them a little bit. The coaches, being able to, and it was mostly kids that I knew in my community that I knew their dads and mothers and stuff. But for them to go on and win the Super Bowl, both teams, the second grade and the third grade, went on to win the Super Bowls. Either way, it was exciting to be a part of, you know, their team and be a part of a Decatur Eagle in our hometown. I didn't get to play football and I didn't get to finish high school. I homeschooled, so it was it's really exciting to be a part of our hometown Decatur Eagles.
So Tev, I have a question. Were they wearing their Tough Cooper pants? Is that how they won?
they had some kind of performance on. I don't know.
So it wasn't Tough Cooper pants. What was their team name? Team names.
The Decatur Eagles. We're the Decatur Eagles in high school, and it goes all the way down to, you know, second grade where they start playing tackle football.
Now, Tuff, you're a busy guy. You don't have to take time to do things like that. And also, you sponsor kids overseas and so like that. And you do so many things that are charity that people don't know about in the outside world. Why do you take time to do that?
I've just had really good examples and really good role models in my life that I've looked up to, and it makes it easy for me just to kind of follow in their footsteps, the people that I look up to. And you know, I'm not you know where I want to be, but I just try to keep looking to their example and
to just keep trying to follow their lead, because I really, the people I look up to do such a great job, and I think it's so important to have good role models and people that you look up to and people that you follow on Twitter, people that you want to be like. You know, it's really important to take your own path and to go take your own journey and go down the road that you want to, and you know, not be a copycat, but it's also really important to look up to the right people. And I've had really great role models and examples in my life that happen to be, you know, mostly my family members.
Who's someone you look up to in your family? I mean, who can you not look up to? But
my uncle Strand Smith has been there, and he's done such a terrific job. He's a champion inside and outside the arena to me. Brother-in-law Trevor Brazil, he can't get any better than that. You know, and my brothers Cliff and Clint, they've done a good job of, you know, kind of helping me get on the right path if I ever kind of tried to go off the wrong path. But Trevor and Strand have been tremendous, and they've been a huge part of, you know, why I'm where I'm at today. And they keep pushing me every day to, you know, to be better.
Okay, well, speaking of Trevor, you just went to the racetrack and raced him, so why'd you let Trevor beat you on the track?
I wanted him to have a lot of confidence coming into the Las Vegas. Last Saturday, Sunday when we got here, me and Trevor went out to the Las Vegas Speedway, and we got in the NASCARs, the stock cars, and put it in fourth gear and went around the track eight times as fast as we could. He did happen to pass me on lap number one. But
it's not a good start.
But, yeah, I think... But that's because I didn't know we were supposed to go in the fourth gear. I was still in third. Then once I found fourth, no, that's all a lie, but he did smoke my tail. I was definitely uncomfortable going that fast, and he was way more comfortable. Or he just wanted to win really bad. I'm not sure. But it was a lot of fun. I felt good. I thought I was on fire when I got out of the car a little bit.
So is that your new... I just called you Ricky Bobby, so if you're not first, you're last, Tough. But is that your new hobby, or are we going to expect to see you on the track?
I don't think I'll go to the professional level. Maybe like
that's
the,
good.
We need to have like a cowboy league. An amateur cowboy, a beginner's cowboy stock car racing league.
So basically you'd be the only contestant.
Basically.
Well, that's not fair. So Tough, okay, we've had some serious conversation and everything. Let's have some fun. Okay, so if you were to go to dinner with one person from the past or present, anybody you want, who would you pick to go to dinner with?
Serious?
Serious, that's a serious question.
All right, there's three people.
No, I said one, okay, three.
John Wayne.
Oh, good one.
The Rock.
What is up with you, The Rock, dude?
I don't know. And DB.
Okay. Why The Rock, though? I just don't understand. Like, do you really think you resemble him?
A little bit. I think we look a lot alike. Like, if I was to shave my head and wear T-shirts all the time, I think we would get mistaken of each other. People would be like, hey, The Rock, what are you doing? They'd be like, I'm Tough.
Well, y'all both have interesting names, so that's something you have in common. And I don't see anything else, though. I'm sorry. No resemblance whatsoever. Okay, so Tough, if you were on a deserted island and it was just you, no one else, just Tough Cooper, what do you think you'd do all day? You don't have a rope.
Don't have a rope.
Nope. Or a spear or anything else.
I would find some form of like rock and make friends with it so I wouldn't be alone.
A rock.
Yeah, something. I'd carry it around with me, have a friend. I don't know.
I feel like I would go swimming or tan.
It worked for
something.
Tom Hanks. Worked for him.
It was a volleyball deer.
It's
okay, no judgment.
All right.
Okay, well, you're still on that island. If you had a choice to bring three items, what three items would you bring?
My mom.
Miss Sherry, good idea.
my dog, and some popcorn. I love popcorn. I don't know.
I mean, you might want to leave the mom or dog at home because you need a microwave.
Got a point. I've already popped popcorn, ready to go.
Well, I hope that popcorn lasts for a long
like a huge,
time because
huge, like a big old like this big. I don't know. What would you choose?
You can't turn it on me.
I've never been in this situation before. I don't know.
I like making you uncomfortable situations. It's kind of funny, but okay, so you're on that island. Who would you want to bring with you? If you had one person to bring with you besides your mom and not three items, because your mom's not really an item, what person would you want to bring with you on the island, like the most efficient person?
DB.
Okay. Why?
He's the king. Because he's the king.
Who would you not want to bring on that? Like, show or the island?
Who would I not want to bring on the island? Nobody? I don't know. Don't put me on the spot like that.
No, it's okay. We won't tell anybody. We're good.
Who would I
no judgment here. This is a no judgment stage.
Who would
stage.
I not want to bring on the island? Well, if there was race cars on the island, I would not want to bring Trevor.
Okay, well, this is a deserted island, so probably no race cars.
I have no idea. I'm not answering. I plead. I'm not going to answer that question.
Have you ever been mean in your entire life?
Beat?
Mean, like, grrr.
No.
Like mean.
Yeah. I don't think so, but I'm sure somebody else would say different. I don't.
Would any of you guys say that Tuff's ever been mean? You could raise your hand. It'd be funny. Oh, his mom. She agrees. You've been mean to your mom? How could you? You're Tuff Cooper.
Really, Mama?
Okay, I have a question, though. I see all these Tuff Cooper Tuesday pictures, and Tuff called me one time, guys, and I'm sitting there talking on the phone. He goes, Alexis, Alexis, and I said, yes. He goes, do you know what day it is? I was like, it's Tuesday, and you know what you have to tell me? And I was like, I'll tell you anything. He's like, happy Tuff Cooper Tuesday, and I was like, oh, God. You have a day after the week after you now, and all those pictures I see, the pictures of you with the kittens and stuff, is that real, or people Photoshop that?
Actually, I Photoshop every one of them.
You Photoshop every one of them to make you look nicer. So baby kittens. Man, that's good. That's a good one.
No, it is so exciting. Every Tuesday, I get so pumped and fired up because on
it's
Twitter.
It's a day about you.
Yes, it is. It is. Not really a day about me, but like sometimes people post stuff on Twitter and Instagram and stuff. And it's really cool and exciting. I like to. It really gives me a good opportunity to get on there and interact with fans and to post stuff that I think's cool. That's probably not cool.
Well, let's talk about your videos. Let's lead to your Instagram videos.
Let's not.
I love your videos.
Let's not.
Hey, guys, Tuff Cooper here. I mean, what's up with the videos? Are you going to keep making them?
I think so. I've recently discovered you can make videos on Instagram. I hadn't gone crazy, but I'll make videos and just, like, talk to myself or talk to whoever's on Instagram and people make fun of me for it for sometimes, like her, but
I would never. I'm appalled that you'd say that.
No, they're fun. They're 15 seconds, and you're like, hey, what's up, everybody? I'm on Instagram.
Yay.
Making a video. Like it and make a comment. What's
you
up?
Tell people to like it?
No.
You have to worry
I
about
should.
That.
I do.
6 million likes later, I'm like, golly. You're a big deal, Tuff Cooper. So tell me, what's it like, the day in the life of Tuff Cooper? Is it fun?
Is it? It's fun. Yes, absolutely. It's every day is full of opportunity for me. It's important. I think it's really important to wake up and, you know, to realize what kind of opportunity you have that day and who gives it to you. If you can wake up and realize that and then move forward with your day, it kind of changes my attitude about, you know, what I get to do and why I get to do it. I'm so blessed to get to do what I love every day when there's millions of people that don't get to. And if I realize that every day, I try to wake up and work as hard as I can and do the best job with the opportunity that I've been given. Most of the time I don't reach it, but every day that I wake up, knowing that why I'm being given this opportunity through our Creator, I try to give my best, if that makes sense at all.
No, that's why you have a day of the week named after you, right there. Positive role model. So, okay, you have a lot of people looking up to you all the time, and you have thousands of people screaming at you when you're at the Thomas and Mac. Do you ever feel pressure?
I don't
You're moving closer. I feel like...
I don't know. Yeah. This is a nice couch you have.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. The Thomas and Mac is the coolest of all. It's packed, sold out every night. It gets really loud. Honestly, sometimes I don't even hear it. I go up there and help Trevor and the team roping. I fix the dirt for him, which I don't know.
Dirt boy.
I look like I'm dancing out there, just kicking the dirt in.
So you can dance?
No.
Don't give me the opportunity.
I cannot dance. I can two-step, not real good. But 18,000 people.
I would love to see that.
I'm just kidding.
Are you going to turn your fans down?
I'm going to need my mom to come give me some lessons real fast. Show me how it's done, and then we can move on.
Oh, my gosh. Well, you make YouTube videos. You do all these crazy things. It's hard being Tough Cooper. But you know who it's probably harder to be? Dale Brisby.
No.
Definitely harder to be tough.
No, it's fun to be me, but how much fun would it be to be Dale Brisby?
Not wear a shirt every day? I have no idea.
I don't even. Yeah.
You should dress like him.
I'm going to dress like him. I'm going to for Halloween.
Okay, well, that was an Alexis exclusive. Everybody remind him he has to dress like Dale Brisby. Okay.
There you go. I don't know. Nobody could look like Dale, though. Dale's his own. He's his own person, and as hard as you want to be like Dale, I don't think anybody could pull it off quite like Dale can.
One of a kind, for sure. You know, I'm kind of scared to call him up here because I feel like it's going to be so bright with the, I'm in the light of greatness between both of y'all. I feel like I said, well, Dale, you know, I'm going to have Tough up there and you, two champions. And I was like, does that make me the loser? And he goes, oh, definitely. Okay. I'm the loser of the bunch.
Dale's here, yeah. Dale's here?
Yeah.
Get out.
I did it for you. You said you wanted it.
Where's Brisby at?
Dale Brisby, they're calling your name.
Let's bring,
aisle one, clean
let's
up.
Bring
Dale
Brisby,
Brisby
out.
Look who's back.
This is a living legend.
What do y'all know good? Wow. Tough Cooper. Good to see y'all, son. Dale Brisby, I'm sure you've heard of me. Thought I was going to have my own chair today, but whatever.
Well, you can have the couch if you want.
Y'all guys can share. Sharing is caring, Dale.
It's all right. I don't mind sharing with Tuff. I mean, me and Tuff been to the winning circle so many times it make a normal man dizzy, all right? Okay, so it's a real treat for y'all to get to hear us up here. So I appreciate you bringing us on.
You're welcome. You know, do you ever have a confidence issue? Do you ever not feel sure of yourself?
Well, you know, I try to be humble, you know. I mean, it's hard sometimes, but, you know, got to be humble around the kids and everything. So, don't want to get cocky.
So, Dale, if you were to describe Tough in one word, what word would you use? Besides champion, besides winner, besides the best, besides anything along those lines.
Well, you know, judging by these first two rounds, I would say prepared. You know, there's a lot that goes into being a champion, you know, and it didn't happen by accident, you know. Last night was the big pin, wasn't it?
It was.
And I'm sure he was up there saying, you know, bring me the big pen, you know, just in the back of his mind. Same thing I'm saying before the bull riding. So, you know, and they put that in slow-mo and just give that, you know, with the flanking those calves, you know. Bust an egg, that calf.
The sound effects make it.
Well, you know, when you're got front row seats every time, you know, from the bucking shoots, you get to hear those kind of things.
Never been there, but Tough, if you were to describe Dale in one word, what word would you use besides winner, champion, funny, anything like that?
That answer's simple.
What's that?
The King.
That's two King.
The King. Thank you. Kings run with kings. There you go.
So, you know, he said if he was stranded on a deserted island, he'd bring you with him. Do you think you'd be good in that situation?
Absolutely. You know, I'm ready to spur down any situation, you know, so be it an island or a bull, whatever, I'll be ready to go 90 points. So.
How funny would it be to see these two on an island together? I'm just picturing in my head, and I'm like, I don't know if I want to picture it because I don't even want to know what they'd talk about. But if you were on an island, do you think you can entertain yourself? How would you entertain yourself?
Well, I'd say I'm like the most interesting person ever, so it'd be hard for me to get bored with myself. So, I mean, entertaining myself, I don't know, just kind of relive those moments of greatness would be, you know what I'm saying? I mean, Tuff and I, we've been to the top so many times, it make a normal man's ears pops like the cereal, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it just kind of comes natural, so.
Well, what makes you the greatest? Why are you better than everybody in bull riding?
Well, you know, it just depends on what you're talking about. If we're talking about spurring bulls, you know, like Tuff, you know, the champion, you know, you got to put in 100% to get out 100%. And then, you know, you got to believe, your achievement level never will raise above your belief level. So you got to know. And I know that I'm the champion, you know. So if you're talking about being on a talk show, you know, it's because y'all know I'm going to tell it like it is, all right? Me and Tuffer, we're so honest, you can shoot dice with us over the phone, all right? So we're going to tell you how it is. That's what made my last girlfriend leave, you know? I said, I just told her how it was. I was like, no, that dress doesn't make you look fat. You look fat because you are fat, you know? And that's the last time. That's the last
thing. Do you want to talk about it? It sounds like you have some problems with the past.
Well, you know, my last serious relationship, Vicky, she left me for a fat steer wrestler on the Blanco River and had a passel of kids. So, no, I don't want to talk about it, Alexis. Thank you.
Hey, Tuff, if you were to think of a celebrity woman, who would you put Dale with? Like, a perfect match for Dale. You better make it good or he's going to come back at you.
I would say somebody like maybe a mix between...
It's tough. I mean, who measures
you
up?
You can't. Exactly. Yeah. I'm trying to think.
It's tough.
You can't measure. You can't. It's, I don't know.
No one's good enough for him, are they?
Well, you know, I like barrel racers. You know, they ride fast horses, and it's convenient because we're the last event. So, you know, I mean, you know, catching a ride with them, you know, makes it. So, as far as matching up, we're just going to need to go with a different criteria.
I would say if you had to choose, if I had to say something, it would be a mix between like Wonder Woman and Catwoman.
Wow.
So, Dale, can you sing?
Yeah, I mean, if the mood strikes me, I guess.
What kind of songs do you like to sing?
I'll sing anything. You know, I'm open for any kind of music. I don't know. Where are you going with this?
I don't know. You want to sing? About some music. Can we get some music? We'll play the singing bee real quick. Okay, so when the music stops, you gotta say the word that was supposed to come there, all right?
Oh, okay, so it's a game.
It's a game.
Okay.
And you're the best at everything, so you better win.
Well,
Tuff, you too. You're playing this.
Better be playing. Better be playing something from the legends, you know? Okay.
Okay, can we have a legend back there? A legend? Music from any legend.
The sound guy's like, oh, we need to play music?
Do you have that album out or something? The Legend?
I was thinking it's a little George. I mean, what more of a legend is there than George Strait? You know, kings run with kings.
Okay,
George.
Fine.
Absolutely. There you go.
Okay, guys, you want to start clapping? Let's give him some little beat.
Nickels and dimes.
See, I've won a lot of those spurring bulls. Okay, so that's why I know that first line the easiest. Go ahead, Tuff. Nickels and dimes, you take it from there.
The same old fool.
Riding bulls and punching fools. George Strait knows how it is. You know what I'm saying? Where do you think he came up with this stuff?
Dale,
nickels and dimes, fools, riding bulls, punching fools.
Dale, how old are you?
Well, Alexis, Granddaddy Brisby lived till he was 102 years old. You know how he did that?
By minding his own business,
all right?
Knew it was coming.
Yeah.
I'm prepared today, Dale. I studied you last night.
Okay.
Do you have a guest? Tough supposedly has a surprise guest. Do you have a surprise guest?
I do have a surprise guest. I want to bring him up. He doesn't have to stay long, but I would just like to bring him up for a second and kind of educate us on, you know, who he is. And it's really an honor for us to have him here and to be a part of Rodeo. He is the 2008 World Series champion in baseball, the catcher. He is from Panama, the country, and his name's Carlos Reese. He's a huge fan of Rodeo. He's been coming out supporting the NFR, supporting the Calf Open for a long time.
That's what
Ladies
we need right
Carlos
there.
Reese.
Welcome.
How are
you?
How are you, Carlos?
Oh, nice. I feel like I'm in a baseball game now. Okay, Tuff, do you hang out with anyone that's not a winner? My goodness. I feel like I am now and the loser on the stage. Literally. So, Carlos, is there any comparison between Rodeo and baseball at all? Any comparison that you would compare?
I mean, first, I want to say thank you to Laura. It's a great opportunity to be here. There's something that I can say. Baseball is my passion, but also Rodeo. When I was little kid in Panama, I always ride horses, so that's something that I have in my heart, and I'm real excited.
We've been up for late hours of the night talking about comparisons between baseball and rodeo, and it's, you know, Carlos is, how many seasons? You know, he's 8 seasons in. The professional, the major leagues, and, you know, for me to talk to him and kind of quiz him and try to pick his brain on experience in different situations would be silly. So, you know, we've spent a lot of hours talking and trying to compare, you know, how things are. Baseball is a lot like rodeo. You know, their season is really long. There's not much rest time. They play all day, nearly every day. They have very few days off during the season, just like our NFR, their championship, the World Series, goes on for 2 weeks. Our championship goes on for 2 weeks. And just talked about, and he's helped me with talking about how to stay, you know, focused on doing my job and on staying focused on the right things instead of the wrong things, staying positive, you know. They got, when he's at bat, he comes around the plate 3 times. He's got 3 chances one night. Whenever I nod my head, I got 1 chance. And it's just about making the most of it and staying focused no matter if you strike out, you know, just to keep swinging no matter what. Stay confident in yourself. And just because you know you got one more opportunity, and just if you get down just a little bit, it's so important just to stay confident in yourself, even if you do strike out the first round.
So, Tuff, how did y'all meet, you and Carlos? Carlos, how did y'all meet each other? How did you meet Tuff?
Tuff was a good friend, Carlos Lee. He's from Panama, too. And Carlos, he take Tuff to his play in Panama. So I went to there. And that was the first time that I met Tuff. And after that, you know, we changed the numbers. And then and the last year, he got an opportunity to go to one of my games in Texas on the opening day. And I was, you know, every star there. And then again, thank you, Tuff, you know. I'm real happy to meet him.
So. Tuff, is he better at you than at roping? Like, does he beat you? Does he beat you in the pen? Yeah?
I tell you what doesn't happen. I don't beat him in baseball.
I wouldn't think so. So has he been helping you with your baseball game and you've been helping him with his roping?
baseball's a lot of fun. I didn't, like earlier, I was saying earlier, I didn't grow up playing a lot of sports. And, you know, to have friends that play it, it gets you more involved into it. And, you know, I want to go out and play some ball. But, I'm still terrible at baseball. I still shouldn't play, but it's a lot of fun. America's pastime. It's fun for everybody.
Baseball and rodeo, America's pastime.
Yes.
Dale, do you have something you want to say?
Well, you know, I love what Tuff said, you know, the overlap between baseball and rodeo. And I believe it was Mickey Mantle that said baseball is 90% mental and the rest is in your head. You know, and that's the same thing about rodeo, bull riding, and some of y'all get that later. But, you know, you got to be focused and all that. You got to do your preparation. But when that pitch is coming in there, when you're about to nod, you know, you gotta know what you're doing up here and be ready, like I said, in everything in life, give 100%, you know, unless you're donating blood. So there is definitely some overlap there. And, you know, a true champion can see that, you know, whether he's throwing a baseball or roping a calf or spurring a bull.
So. Do you have a question for him, Dale? Do you have anything you want to ask him?
Well, you know, now that I've, you know, Carlos back there asked if he could take a picture with me, and of course I obliged, but it doesn't take long for a champion to recognize a champion to recognize a champion, and it's kind of like E.T. and Elliot. We just kind of sync together, and we just feel like we know each other already, you know? And so, I don't have too many questions. I feel like I know you. Yeah.
Oh, we're flexing up here. Flexing.
What did I say, what?
He say he can pitch, like maybe he can hit like 100 miles an hour.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
he say it was strong. That's what we're talking behind them.
Yeah. I mean, you throw a fastball at me, and I'm gonna hit it. I'm gonna compete. Whatever the equivalent of a 90 point bull ride is what's gonna happen. So, you know, you throw it in there 90 miles an hour, I'm gonna spur it out of the park. You know what I'm saying? So you can expect that. Same thing with these guys in their respective sports.
I don't even want to know what your first impression was of me, Dale, because you just said you could tell by walking back there that he was a champion. I didn't ask you. No, you don't have to answer.
Okay.
No, God. No, no, no. So do you stay at the NFR the entire duration? Do you stay out here the whole time?
Just the first weekend. Did you come? Yeah, about three or four rounds. First three or four rounds this year. Yes. Yeah, yeah. He but also when he's in town, he goes out to a baseball park and helps some kids and goes and makes an appearance and helps the kids get better at baseball. So it's, you know, he's knocking it out here, so it's cool that he does that.
I feel like I'm sitting next to you guys really are champions in and out of the arena. Dale, I don't know if you do community service, but I'm just saying that all you guys do things, you take time to do things. This is community service? No, it's not.
It's benefiting the community.
It's benefiting the community.
Benefiting the community.
Okay.
Community of rodeo. Blessing y'all with our presence. My presence.
So, Carlos, why do you do that? Why do you take time to go out and help these kids with baseball?
Yeah, I think, you know, give it back to the kids and try to teach, you know, them, try to give it to the kid, you know, the everything that I learned when I would start playing baseball. This everything I think is about, you know, about the passion, about your heart, about like tough, you know, you wanna be like the best, the number one in the world. And that's all the mentality that I was trying to give it to the young kid, you know. But first, don't forget about school. You know, school is very important. But it's something like you want to be. I think myself, it was a little hard for me in Panama because we don't have a draft over there. And then they take a lot of work for me, you know, to make to the big league. Just looking for the opportunity to play professional baseball. And what I can say to little guys and any sport, you know, just, you know, work hard, respect, you know, the game, respect the score, and one day you have the opportunity to make, you know, and any place that you want to be.
Well, I know I can speak for myself, and I'm sure for the rodeo community, we're glad to have you as a fan of rodeo for sure. We need more people like you supporting rodeo. Okay, well, you guys ready to have some music? Yeah? He ended on a good note. He's like, respect yourself, respect the game. I feel like I just got a pump-up speech. I could go run a mile right now. Please welcome Miss Kylie Frye, who just released a video, Rodeo Man.
Hey, how y'all doing today? Good? Well, my name is Kylie Frye. I'm from Opelousas, Louisiana. And I wrote a song called Rodeo Man. And about a month ago, you know, my team, we were talking and we were planning on doing a video for this song. And so they were like, well, you need to find us a rodeo man. So it's like, well, there's a lot of guys we could use, but who better than the one and only Tuff Cooper? So we called Miss Sherry and Tuff, and they were more than happy to full-heartedly jump in and give their time. And so I'm going to play my song for y'all, and then we'll play the video.
Stand between you and your golden dreams before you catch that road to San Antonio. Could you leave this girl a little piece of hope? Hey, rodeo man, I ain't the rope you hold. Palm of your hand, you can't hang on and let go when you feel the need. But when you're done chasing bubbles, would you ride on home to me? Took everything I had just to watch you leave. Praying perfect rides and highways will bring you back to me. But it's a day that's hanging on your mind when the motel's getting cold at night. It's hard to think what you might find. But it won't be a love as good as mine. Hey, rodeo man, I ain't the rope you hold, the palm of your hand. You can't hang on and let guess somehow I've always been too late.
Thank you.
Wow, I wish I could sing at all. We should have just, I'm sorry, Dale, but we should have just let her sing from the start.
That was amazing. You have some, you got some pipes.
That means a lot coming from you.
And I see what you did there with the hold on to me, like bull rope, you know, like hold on to me. Like, I caught that and
this
it was
awesome.
This is
why he's a champion.
Yeah, I mean, hey, right here, right here. Also, you're beautiful.
Guys, keep in mind Dale. She said, I was looking for Rodeo Cowboy, and Dale's like, me. He was a little upset that you didn't choose him. Let's give it up for Miss Kylie Frye, guys. And she's about to model, so we're going to have a little style show for you because today is rock and roll day, rock and roll cowboy, rock and roll cowgirl, and Tuff's going to narrate for the guys, and then we have the manager, or the, goodness, the head of merchandising for Panhandle coming up, Miss Gina. And then also we have Catherine over there. She's like, no, I don't want to be introduced, but they help me out so much. So Miss Gina, we're going to have some fun, and you're going to tell everybody what they're wearing.
Okay, so we are going to see some models today and some endorsees wearing our products. We're going to talk about it a little bit. And I'm going to talk about Rock and Roll Cowgirl, and Tuff's going to talk about his line with us, which is the Tuff Cooper line by Panhandle. And we're ready.
By the record machine, I knew he must have been about 17. He was going strong, playing my favorite song, and I could tell it would be long.
So this is Kylie, who you guys just heard sing, and she's beautiful, and she can sing pretty, and she wears our product very well. She's got on Rock and Roll Cowgirl jeans with the little bling pocket, and a really cute little tie-dye top that has a little cold shoulder. Very cute.
Not only will the performance jeans increase your chances of winning, but it'll increase your chances of getting it on in the dance floor. Because I've seen Billy Bob dance before he put those jeans on, and he wasn't real sharp. But that's the performance jean, and it looks great. We got a nice model, Billy Bob Brown, here with us, and that is the Panhandle shirt. That's awesome.
It's your shirt.
A performance shirt. And that's my performance shirt. It has the great fit, feel. It does it all for you.
And little Miss Laramie here has on Rock and Roll Cowgirl jeans with some bling on the side seam, bling on the pockets, real cute little foil headdress, and some eyelash sleeves. And this is Bailey, and Bailey has on Bailey has on a leopard print top from Rock and Roll Cowgirl and some really cool riding jeans, which is a little more room for performance as well for all the cowgirls.
Well, Tuff's gonna let me take over right here. The first thing I see about these jeans, they got a great fit to them. They're not gonna fall down behind the heel, but they don't look like hot waters. And here's the thing is, the longer you wear these jeans, you're eventually gonna have a gold buckle holding them up. So that's the thing about these jeans here that you guys need to realize. So it's more than denim, okay?
And Holly has on Rock and Roll Cowgirl, little black dress with some fringe on the
Cole Elster, who's competing out here. He's the panhandle guy. Come on, Cole, spin around. Show your stuff. See, his butt looks so good in these jeans. Your butt could look good today, so go purchase some.
What do you think, Brisby?
Watching Cole these first two rounds, I need to get me a pair of these. He handled the eliminator pin handily. It's not going to be long before he has a gold buckle. And what Carlos just said, bueno, that means good in Spanish.
Her butt looks good too. Oh, wait for it, it's coming. Dynamite comes in small packages, and so does rock and roll.
Yeah, this little guy, Bradley, has on rock and roll cowboy jeans. Has on a really cool panhandle shirt.
Hey, Dale, he just won second in the bull riding over there.
That right there is a fun-sized champion. That's what you got there.
And we saved the best for last. Little Miss Sunny Lynn, and she's got on rock and roll cowgirl jeans. 17. The light of bling on her little
tank. Work, girl. You work. And I could
tell it would be long.
Well, guys, that's all we have today, is if you didn't have enough. But thanks for coming to Alexis Glimmer Live. Be sure to come tomorrow. We have a great guest lineup.